The top row will be left empty.
So I made it. It is just my thought process in fast motion, and I wanted to explain it a little bit. So when you have these built-ins, there's always a deeper shelf on the bottom, so certain items can only live on the bottom, so they choose their places real fast because they're too deep for any other shelf. I also like some things to be balanced, but not everything, because that obviously looks crazy. But like, for example, wherever this guy went, I just put this guy. So if I move this one over here, I'd move that one over there. Some balance I think is good. I also keep track of greenery. One plant over here and one over here, and then you can see there's one up here and flowers over here. So I'd never want to put the plants too close. I'd want kind of a balance of green on each side, although it's fine to have two green things in one green thing. I think it's almost better that way because it's less perfectionist. I also stack books by color, but not insanely. Like there's some gray ones with black ones. This one's just like the cream, tan, and gold family. These go green, blue, back to green, and yellow. So I wasn't trying to be insane about it, but I was trying to group them by eye. All the dark books went up here. That has a ton of visual weight, so the rest of the shelf was lighter objects. So basically, it's looking with your eye at what things kind of connect and balancing them. So for example, over here we had something gold. So I tried to do something gold over here. Over here we had something wood tones and woven tones. So we've got wood-ish tones, some wood on the side of that, and the wood in the frame. It would be less of a success, I think, if you noticed all the wood was over here, all the greenery was over here, all the gold was over here. So that's what I was doing when I was playing with things. But all told, this probably took about 25 to 30 minutes of me playing around. One big tip for you is make things groupings and then just move the groupings. You'll notice sometimes I change the object on top of things, but like this stack of books went in and it pretty much stayed there. This stack of the black books went in, I added more black books, and then that was a set. So by making larger objects into sets, the stack of boxes, for example, I added a bowl on top to give it some height. You can put little things in there like coins or travel memorabilia, a lot of storage in here with things, and then of course, book storage. And the cool thing about this is that this is also full of books. So there's lots of books that are out, and maybe the books they don't want to look at are in there, but still very easy access. They have games under here and toys under here. I feel like it's a wall that works really hard for their health. I hope that was helpful. Also, they have fresh roses, and I'm very jealous.